الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا
نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره نعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن أصدق الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها فإن كل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وإنما توعدون لآت وما أنتم بمعجزين. In this khutbah, inshallah, I would like to share with you some thoughts. I had thought to talk to you about Thanksgiving, but as you know already, Thanksgiving gone for non-Muslims, but for Muslims, we always give thanks at all times, day and night, in the time of ease as well as the time of difficulty. And changed my mind about the khutbah since it was yesterday and there's nothing too much you can do about it if you ate turkey or you didn't. If you gather with the family or not, if you try to celebrate it or not. But I got a phone call last night from California all the way down and the sister called me and asked me, are you part of Amja? Was a surprising question. Why? What it is? Somebody asking me, are you part of Amja, which is a fatwa organization that here in America. So I said, but what is the question, you understand? Sort of, yes. What is the question? Say, because I just read a fatwa about the permissibility or it's okay for Muslims to celebrate Thanksgiving. I said, sister, doesn't matter if they say do it or not, I don't support this. And I can feel the agony and the disturbance of Muslims when they hear things and they go to another website and somebody else is telling them haram, somebody else is telling them makruh, somebody tells them it's shirk. And after this, the fatwa will be from here and there, and a person will be wonder which way to go. My concern here today is not about talking about Amjad, although I have my own personal experience with some of fatwa that been legislated or been given by fatwa. I know the people personal because I attend their conference. And I supposed to be one of the expertise there, or they call it khabir, or whatever term they want, okay? But believe it or not, I had read a shocking fatwa from place like Amjad as example. And one of them, fatwa concerning buying a mosque or building Islamic school out of usury, or out of borrow money from the bank. And I wrote the sheikh who wrote it. I disagree with him. I told him, how you can say such a thing? And this is what Allah said. Does not mean because you sit with the people that you agree with them about everything. But also, we have to have the means and the ways and the tools that we can check what somebody saying. There is no book that is perfect other than the book of Allah. There is no a person that could not a mistake make a mistake other than the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Allah had make him ma'soom concerning the revelation. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told him to take it easy, okay? لا تحرك بي لسانك لتعجل به. إن علينا جمعه وقرآن. فَإِذَا قَرَأْنَاهُ فَاسْتَمِعْ قُرْآنَ فَاتَّبِعْ قُرْآنَ ثُمَّ إِنَّ عَلَيْنَا بَيَانَ. Oh Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't hasten with the Quran when Jibreel saying it and you try to say it in the same time out of concern of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put him at ease. He said, don't worry. It is our job, i.e. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we collect it and we make you read it. And we also going to explain it to you. But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we understand that he made a mistake in Salah. Regardless was a tashri' for tashri' or that he did it. But somebody corrected the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam after the Salah. Questioning the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, O Prophet of Allah, did you forget? Or something changed, the prayer been shortened? What was the answer of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? I didn't forget, neither the prayer is shortened. He said, no, O Prophet of Allah, that you made a mistake now. Now you forgot. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned to the Sahaba and say, is it true what he's saying, Zul Yadayn? Is what this man is saying? His nickname is Zul Yadayn. Is it right? They said, yes, O Prophet of Allah. So here the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stood up, made two rak'at, and after this we learn about sujood al-sahu, to prostrate after your prayer as a result of forgetfulness in salah, to perfect and complete your prayer. So it doesn't matter if you call it Amjad, you call it Naif, you call it Fatwa Center, all these names is still ill, unless a person have an ill desire in his own soul and searching, they call it fatwa shopping, try to find somebody who will give him something that fits what he inclined towards. I heard from the same, not the same person, but part of Amjad, and he was sitting on the minasa, on the pulpit, and giving a lecture, and I was sitting listening there, and saying, no, but I'm talking about a certain type of music, you understand, for relaxation, I think, not the craziest. I say, brother, which hadith had give you the ability to distinguish between two different types of music? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told us that this is one of the signs of the day of judgment. All the music are haram. How did you come with this? So I hear weird things, okay? So it's not everything a fatwa line or a organization or anybody have to be as if it's coming as a revelation. Let's come back again to our subject. Doesn't matter who said right or wrong. You have to be have the means and the tools that you go and search and ask Allah. We make dua sincere that Allah guide you to as-sirat al-mustaqim and let you see it, because وَمَنْ لَمْ يَجْعَلِ اللَّهُ لَهُ نُورًا فَمَا لَهُ مِنْ نُورٍ. Whosoever Allah doesn't give him sight and light to see, he could not see. And I have at least some few adilla or evidence that I want to present it to you to let you know that we are not supposed to be celebrating such occasion. And you're going to have a lot now, starting with November, and when it comes now the rush hour in December, now you're going to have all this kind of kafir holidays. And some people say, brother, but we're here in America. Yes, I know we are in America. I'm not asking you to take a machine gun and going to be against America. You have to still, and you have to be settled, and you have to be stable with your belief. It's not part of your belief, you go and fight the people. But you have to have your own personality as a Muslim. You have your identification as Islam and Muslims, not as American or not as a China. This means that you're going to be China, you're going to be a Chinese. And if you go to Arabia, you become Arab. No, we have certain things that this is our identification. Called Islam, Muslims, and this comes by the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. As example, when the Prophet, so if, even if it's not haram, it's not makruh, it's not disliked, what are you doing? Thanksgiving started by Muslims? No. I mean, Zaid. And by the way, that Zaid is from Ada Ya'udu, so this became Eid. It's things that comes again and again and again. All right? This is became Eid. And you can go to Google, go any place and ask for holidays in America. You'll find Thanksgiving is one of them. This itself is telling you it is a holiday. They're giving you a break. You don't have to go to your job. People travel, people celebrate, people eat in turkey. And even now they say halal turkey. We understand all these things. But this is not going to make something makruh to be sunnah or to be halal. We have to understand how we understand not to celebrate other festival or other occasions that not belong to the Muslims. Does not mean that we have to be the enemy of the American people, but we did not contribute to it, neither we became part of it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in the hadith in authentic Bukhari and Muslim, inna li kulli qawmin eida wa hadha eiduna. Every nation, every people, they have their own feast, and this is our feast. So feast is not became up to you and me. Somebody celebrating birthday, and somebody celebrating Thanksgiving, and somebody celebrating Christmas and Eve and all these things. We have to understand that Eid became a part of Islam, when and how and where to celebrate. So we could not mix these things and the whole thing became like a salad plate in front of you. We have something called Islam, and anything that is foreigner from Islam, we don't adopt its symbol like this. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, for every nation that there is a feast, a time of celebration, and this is our Eid. So we have our own Eid. We did not participate in other people's Eid. When the Prophet sallallahu and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala saying لِكُلِّ مِنْكُمْ جَعَلْنَا شَرِعَةً وَمِنْهَاجًا. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made for every nation, they have their own feast and their own Sharia. We are not supposed to pray, as example, with putting your hands like this in your khasr, because this is the prayer how the Yahud is supposed to pray. But we, معاشر الأنبياء نضع اليمين على الشمال. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we are the community of the prophets. We put In our prayer, our right hand on our left hand. So these people, they have their own salah. And we have our own salah. They have their own methodology, and we have our own methodology. He's the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he went to the Medina, and he found the people celebrating. And he said, what it is? He says, this is days that we inherited from the time of Jahiliyyah. Okay? We used to celebrate this before Islam, so we continue doing this. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had told them, إِنَّ اللَّهَ تَبَارَكَ وَتَعَالَى أَبْدَلَكُمْ بِهِمَا خَيْرًا مِنْهُمَا يَوْمُ الْأَضْحَى وَيَوْمُ الْفِطْرِ. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, indeed Allah had replaced you. Okay, this is better, this is badil. I take this away from you, and I'm giving you something to replace it. He said, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had replaced you with other 2 days that much better than them. So how we can leave the choice of Allah? Allah chose for us to eat. 2 occasions, celebration, okay? We did not mix things together. If Allah choose Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha to be our feast, so we don't have any other occasions. We have to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam are the ones who draw the line, not me and you. There is something called blueprint. And if you go 1 inch out of the blueprint, the inspector will come and say, sir, I'm sorry, you need to take this wall down and you're going to have to rebuild it, otherwise I'm not giving you. This is it. Allah draws a line. Allah gave you replacement. Allah gave you something different, what you call Eid al-Fitr and Eid al-Adha. When one of the Sahaba came and he made another vow, the promise, he made a commitment to Allah that I'm going to fast at such a place or such a time. And when he came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, saying, O Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he wants to make the sacrifice. This is his intention, this is his sacrifice, or this is his vow to Allah, if Allah fulfills such a thing. So he made another, he came to Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, because he wants to sacrifice a camel in such a place. What was the question of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? هَلْ كَانَ فِيهَا وَثَنٌ مِّنْ أَوْثَانِ الْجَاهِلِيَّةِ يُعْبَدْ. Was any idols or statues or anything used to be worshipped in that place from the time of Jahiliyyah? He said, no. He said, فَهَلْ كَانَ فِيهَا عِيدٌ مِّنْ أَعْيَادِهِمْ. That they used to have a celebration in that place before? He said, no, O Prophet of Allah. He said, so, أَوْفِ بِنَذْرِ. So now fulfill your commitment that you made it for Allah. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his main question is what? Is there something from the athar or the impact of the occasion of the Jahiliyyah pre-Islam as a wasan or as a feast? Since both of them was not, so the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to him, fulfill your promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So from this, my dear respected brothers and sisters, that we have to understand that all this occasion which is man-made or religious group made, and this had started, as you know, in the years 1600 by a Catholic group that migrated from England about Thanksgiving. But look the beauty of Islam. أَتَسْتَبْدِلُونَ الَّذِي هُوَ أَدْنَى بِالَّذِي هُوَ خَيْرٌ. Why we may exchange with something bad and lesser than the good? What is the good? Allahu Akbar, Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. How many times? Every day 17 times you praise in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sami'a Allahu liman hamida. How many times? At least 17 times every day you praise in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And you continue all your salah in hamd and the praise and thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We don't have to wait for one single day to show our gratitude to Allah all the time. In every time Allah bless us with something, or that even he take away something from us. Not only because Allah gave me a child, now I'm going to prostrate sajd shukr to Allah. No, even if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take my child, he die, I still what? Alhamdulillah. See the beauty of Islam. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a house in Jannah to be the name Baytul Hamd, the house of praise. Allah said to the angels, did you take the soul of my slave, his son? Did he take the fruit of his eye, the coolness of his heart? You took it away. Say, yes, Allah, yes, Allah. Say, what did my slave say? Said, oh Allah, hamadaka wastarja. Hamidaka wastarja. He praised you and he said, inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un. This is the beauty of Islam. 24/7 that you are in praise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even after you finish your prayer, you say subhanallah, and then you say alhamdulillah 33 times. This is beauty. But people wait for one day, and now they're going to celebrate, and look how they celebrate. Boyfriends and girlfriends and drinking, may I understand, khamra and all this haram, and this is supposed to be Thanksgiving. And now we fall. We could not be tales. We could not be tales all our life. How many non-Muslims they celebrate Eid al-Fitr or Eid al-Adha? Why Muslims always have to be tails? Why we lose our identification as a Muslims? This is the most thing important that we have to hold to it, that Islam. What Islam gives us, this is what we take. What Islam turns away from, this is what we have to stay away from it. It's too much, my brothers. It's too much, my sisters. And now even people going to understand about halal turkey. What is make haram turkey and halal turkey now? And now people, they did not have any more halal turkey. What stop you to eat turkey the day before yesterday? What stop you to eat the turkey today? But the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had informed us and foretold us and prophesied, لَتَتَّبِعُنَّ سَنَنَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ شِبْرًا بِشِبْرٍ وَذِرَاعًا بِذِرَاعٍ. We could not be a tail. This Muslim Ummah Allah created to be ahead, to be a leader, to be example, to be uswa. He did not create them to be tails to follow other nations. Allah made them to be leaders in every good things. So why don't you eat turkey today? Why it have to be a brother was he understands that the cheapest times that you can buy turkey. Okay, buy it. But it is a freezer. Why you could not wait until Friday? So we don't know why, but became a part of. So now we lose our identity as Muslims. We losing it, you understand? In the way you talk, the way you celebrate, the way you dress, the way you act, everything become almost like a kuffar. And this was the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had prophesied and told us that you will follow the footsteps of those people, other people. And you will do it exactly inch by inch, mile by mile. This was happening. If they eat in turkey, we could not eat tuna fish. What's wrong with tuna fish? It have to be turkey. And if it's Thursday, it has to be Thursday. In November, it has to be November. And it has to be Thursday. The last says, why? Why? We are a nation that Allah created us to be showing a good example for the other nations. So now when we are defeated inside, that we have nothing except to look right and left to see what other people doing, and we have to do it, and after this we sit ugly about it. Is it haram? Is it makruh? Is it that? Is that? Is it shirk? It's what it is. Is it been done by Umar? Is it, they don't know about things? Is it done by Abu Bakr? Is it done by the Sahaba? This is the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam recommended. Why we have to be jumping for every cause that comes, doesn't matter. We have to be Muslim in everything that we do, and we have to understand when to celebrate and when not to celebrate. الحمد لله رب العالمين وأصلي وأسلم على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين. It's a moment for me to stand before you here and give thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the newborn one. I had prayed and asked Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala extend my life before this book. Yes, I had many books, but this was one thing that I've been dreaming about it to come out before I die. It was a big struggle, and it's going to be a controversial book. It's not an easy book. It will be loved by many people and will be hated by many people. And I'm letting you know this. Why? I want to tell you something before I tell you about the new born baby, which you're supposed to adopt it. It's your son, Imam, yes. But you can help me to pamper this child, get him some clothes, to dress him. You can babysit him sometimes, okay? Here, I want to share with you some of the ahadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He said, Bada al-deenu ghariban, and fi riwaya, Bada al-islamu ghariban. But basically, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is saying that this religion, this Islam, had started as a stranger. Who's this? I didn't see him before. Oh, he's not from out of town? No, he doesn't look even like us. He's not a stranger. أجعل الآلهة إلها واحدا. What's wrong with this man? Talking about the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He made all gods to be only one God. Doesn't work like this. This is a way, stranger to them. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam telling us that this deen had started as a stranger. And guess what? Be careful, because we'll come back again. That means we'll go all the way up and became a Islamic society and khilaf and everything, but will come times that وَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا وَسَيَعُودُ غَرِيبًا كَمَا بَدَى and will return back to the same state that it start with, to be stranger among the people. Somebody say, why you always after Jumu'ah? I never see you. Maybe once a blue moon that you raise your hands and you make dua after khutbah. Say, brother, because this is bid'ah. Brother, everything is bid'ah. First of all, this was the way to make dua. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he made dua, he made it with the finger like this. Then there is no any narration to tell you the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, after every Jum'ah, he had made dua. Maybe once every blue moon, there is an emergency case he did. There is nothing to say that before you end your khutbah. إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا say brother you don't love to send صلاة على الرسول I send صلاة على الرسول in تشهد after سلام before I make دعاء but who said that it have to be in خطبة الجمعة it became so flourish everywhere you go China you go Arabia you go wherever you found this was as the people think that this part of the way how the خطبة to be I'm telling you, it's going to be a stranger. And we already had started to see many things from the sunnah of the Prophet. Are you a terrorist? Hey man, what are you talking about? I'm a Muslim man. Oh, but why is this thing yonder? What do you mean thing? You don't know what the name of a thing? Look, brother, people in America. Thank you, brother. I know where I am. But you know, okay, but... Subhanallah, Allah made it easy, but people still. If the people, the hippies, grow their beard, we're ready to have a beard. If the fashion became a beard, now we grow beard. But when the Muslim became a Muslim and they want it, no, now we'll be terrorists. And when the Jew, his beard will be longer than your Imam's beard, he's not a terrorist, but the Imam is terrorist. Why? What's going on? What is going on? This exactly the prophecies. Wallahi, brothers, listen, you don't need evidence about Islam. Read and understand and see the application. This is the Prophet said that this religion would turn back again to be stranger among the people. We see it nowadays. A Jew, you find him with a beard like all the way here, and with a hat, with a coat, and you found his hair coming from the side, you understand? But nobody can look at him and say, oh, look. You don't have, you understand, to look like this to be a Jew. No, he believes in what he believes. And he's proud to practice what he believes. Most of us have been defeated. And if you are defeated inside, forget about everything else. Because you already don't. Now you're ready to receive any germs coming. if you're eating right, you have this strength, you're jogging in the morning, you're doing all the things, now you're stronger than a person that receiving all the germs. Somebody sneezes, oh brother, okay, what brother and sister all sneezed, okay. MashaAllah, Allah give you enough soldiers inside to protect you for, but say, brother, but it's, I'm telling you, we're receiving a lot. Little of da'wah we're giving out. So we became available to take anything stranger, and some of us became part of this, what the Prophet says, that we ourselves became part of making Islam to be stranger, wal'iyadhu billah. But I have a glad tidings for you that the Prophet gave it to us. He said what? فَطُوبَ لِلْغُرَبَاءِ. A blessing, a great reward in Jannah for those who are a stranger. Those who are a stranger. How you be a stranger? Those who try to revive this deed. Those who try to correct and bring things back to track according to the Book of Allah and the Sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So if somebody told you that you are a stranger, do not be offended. Say, Alhamdulillah, that Allah had made me among them. He said, those people, الَّذِينَ يُصْلِحُونَ مَا أَفْسَدَ النَّاسِ مِنْ بَعْدِي مِنْ سُنَّتِي. Those people who will correct and bring things back from what the people forgot and neglect and abandoned and from my sunnah. May Allah make us among those people. And the Prophet ﷺ also had told us, don't be worried, it's going to happen. But it's going to happen by you or by somebody else. If you are not going to be one of them, Allah will bring something. And if you turn away, Allah will bring other people and they will do it. Be part of being a person who renews this Islam. The Prophet ﷺ said every century, the beginning of every century, Allah will raise one or a people who will revive this deen, bring it back to understanding and correct understanding. You don't want to be one of the strangers. You don't want to be part of those people whom Allah used them as a tools to bring the sunnah back to defeat the bid'ah. My brothers and sisters, today I'm calling you in the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. No, wallahi, I don't need your money. I don't need it. I have. And I can make another book and another book. But I don't want to be also what you call miser, that I won't eat everything for myself, take all the blessing for myself. Alhamdulillah, I try to work hard to put the book. For 40 years, I've been searching for a book about bid'ah since I came to America. I found two booklets, one of them maybe six sheets, and one of them came from India or Pakistan, and basically this. This is a 77 pages and been written not only to identify what is bid'ah and what is sunnah, is only giving you also, is giving you practicality. What is the bid'ah when you celebrate it? After somebody die, as example, what you call Quran Khan or whatever it is, or making the Arba'iniyya, Sanawiyya, and they bring it big sheikh and recite Quran and giving him $200 and all. Talk about wedding, about prayer, about making dhikr, the imam leading you after salah. Assalamu alaykum rahmatullah, assalamu alaykum Allah. Adhkurullah ka dhikr kathira wa sabbihu bukrata wa asila. La ilaha illa subhanallah. And everybody go 33. And after this, the imam will jump again, leading you. Same way he lead you in salah, he lead you in the dhikr. Where is this in the sunnah? You can go and see it in different countries and in different Islamic institutions. And people think, why is this new imam that came to the community, he doesn't make the dhikr? Why he doesn't make the du'a? And people wonder, why? Because people start to think that this is the sunnah. My new baby is here, alhamdulillah, a newborn. Today is the aqiqah, and you're going to be part of this aqiqah, inshallah. All what I'm asking you is that you donate to get one box of these books. I'm not going to ask you for the cost price, for the sale price. I'm asking you at least, you donate $200 for one box, more than 100 books in each box. You know what? I can keep it for 10 years. the storage room if Allah extend my life. People, even if you tell them $1, they don't want. Why? Because they already see no left turn and this is bid'ah. They don't want to hear about bid'ah. They don't like to hear about it, okay? You make a revolution in their life. You make a revolution in their mosque. They don't want to hear about it. It's not every imam can stand up and dare to talk about things like this. But alhamdulillah, with the support of the Muslims of Colombia, that they show their passion with their imam for 35 years, preaching them, correcting them, and sometimes they smile, and sometimes they understand, they argue, but alhamdulillah, you've been supportive. Now we want to send this book free to the masajid. Because when you want to buy it, you want to sell it to him, no, he sees the name bid'ah, he doesn't want to touch it even. I say, brother, I have a lot of books in mind. I don't want, wow, what's good? He's scared to touch it. Take the book. I'm asking you that you make a donation today, adopt the clothing for my son or my daughter or whatever you call it, okay? Help me to raise this child. Help me for clothing, feeding this child. Take it to another Muslim. You pay the money, I ship it to the masajid. Or you take the box, you give me $200, and you get more than 100 books in one box. You do whatever you want to do it. Even if you want to go and sell it, it's fine with me. But I want you to get the blessing. To be part of the ghuraba, part of the strangers, those people who supported the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, be part of this good. And I end my khutbah with the saying of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, إِذَا مَاتَ ابْنَ آدَمَ انْقَطَعَ عَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثٍ صَدَقَةٍ جَارِيَةٍ أَوْ عِلْمٌ يُنْتَفَعُ بِهِ أَوْ وَلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُو لَهُ. When son of Adam die, all his good deed or her good deed is ceased, stopped, with exception of three things. A continuous charity. So every time that somebody will read, now this is continuous charity. You go from masjid to masjid, as long as people using it, the charity will come to you in your grave while you are dead. أو علم أو علم ينتفع به, useful knowledge. This is the useful knowledge. The knowledge of Quran and Sunnah. This or a righteous son. Today is your opportunity. Show your gratitude. Show your thanks to Allah today by adopting the book. And if anybody wants, put $11,000 and get the whole things that I print is yours. But I know we have to be reasonable. And I don't think $200 is going to be a big deal. You don't have it, you can make a commitment that you get 50 next month and 50 next year, doesn't matter. Alhamdulillah, Allah has sufficed me that I can go work, write, publish, even give it in free if I want. So it's not a matter that I need. They say, oh, brother, I was going to pay my electric bill, but you said, brother, I feel bad for you. No, don't feel bad in me, okay? My electric bill been paid, the rent been paid. I don't need your money. I want you to be part of this. So in the day of a judgment, you be proud that you did something to revive the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam.
الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح قد قامت الصلاة قد قامت الصلاة الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
استوى اعتدلوا تراصوا straighten the line part of the salah استوى استووا straight the line please the next one to your left please the rest of the line please look to your right side please and straighten the line
الله أكبر
الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الحمد لله رب العالمين الرحمن الرحيم مالك يوم الدين إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين اهدنا الصراط المستقيم صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين قل يا أيها الكافرون لا أعبد ما تعبدون ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد ولا أنا عابد ما عبدتم ولا أنتم عابدون ما أعبد لكم دينكم ولي دين الله أكبر سمع الله لمن حمده الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر السلام عليكم ورحمة الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله إن شاء الله برزس